Good morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Our Mass will be broadcast live online on the official Facebook page of the Abbey and on the Abbey's official YouTube channel. We request that all unnecessary noise be avoided, that our mobile phones are turned off, and that our kids and toddlers are controlled. Thank you. In today's Mass, we include in our prayer all the members of our respective families, relatives, friends, employees, oblates, and benefactors of this Abbey. We also remember the intentions of all those participating online, especially the intentions they have just sent in. Today is the rite of Abbatial Blessing of our new Abbot, in the person of the Right Reverend Father Savio Maria C. Siccuan, OSB. He is the second abbot of our Abbey of the Transfiguration. The principal celebrant of this abbatial blessing is His Excellency Jose Araneta Cabantan, Archbishop of Cagayan de Oro. He will be assisted by our Abbot Emeritus Eduardo P. Africa, OSB, and by Abbot Emeritus Filomeno Cinco, OCSO, of the Trappist Abbey of Our Lady of the Philippines in Guimaras. The rite of the blessing of an abbot by the bishop is referred to in the Holy Rule of Saint Benedict and attested to half a century later under Pope Saint Gregory the Great in the 7th century. The rite of blessing is composed of the presentation of the abbot to the bishop by two of his monks, Prior Dom Juan Diego Maria Presillas, OSB, and Sub-Prior Dom Joaquin Francisco Maria Hayatin, OSB. Then a brief questioning, and finally the solemn blessing, which is preceded by the Litany of the Saints. The rite is concluded with a handing over of the rule and the abbatial insignia, the ring, mitre, and crozier. And then the new abbot is given the kiss of peace by his monks. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God.
And to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who give the priest Saint Jerome a living and tender love for sacred scripture, grant that your people may ever be more fruitfully nourished by your word and find in it the fount of life. Grant, we pray, O Lord, to your servant Dom Savio, whom you have chosen as abbot of this community, of the Abbey of the Transfiguration of the Lord, that by his deeds and teaching he may guide the hearts of his brothers towards those things that are right, and so receive joyfully with them the recompense of an eternal reward from you, the most loving shepherd. So our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Then the Lord answered Job from the whirlwind and said, "Have you ever in your life commanded the morning and made the dawn known its place, so that it would take off the ends of the earth and the wicked would be shaken off from it? It is changed like clay under the seal, and they stand out like garment. Their light is withheld from the wicked, and the uplifted arm is broken. Have you entered the springs of the sea and walked in the depth of the ocean? Have the gates of death been revealed to you? And have you seen the gates of deep darkness? Have you understood the expanse of the earth? Tell me if you know this. Where is the way to the dwelling of light and darkness? Where is its place, that you would take it to its territory and discern the paths to its home? You know, for you were born then, and the number of your days is great." Then Job answered the Lord and said, "Behold, I am insignificant. And what can I say in response to you? I put my hand on my mouth. I have spoken once, and I will not reply, or twice, and I will add nothing more." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. just man shall flourish like the palm tree. Like a cedar of Lebanon shall he grow. They that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
Lord, it is good.
Shall bear fruit even in old age, vigorous and sturdy, and they shall be, declaring how just is the Lord, my rock, in whom there is no wrong.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The disciples devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of the bread and to the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day, they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to the breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Today, if you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to them, "The light will be among you only a little while. Walk while you have the light, so that darkness may not overcome you. Whoever walks in the dark does not know where he is going. While you have the light, believe in the light, so that you may become children of the light." After he had said this, Jesus left and hid from them. Although he had performed so many signs in their presence, they did not believe in him, in order that the word which Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled. Lord, who has believed in our preaching, to whom has the might of the Lord been revealed? For this reason, they could not believe, because again, Isaiah said, he blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, so that they might not see with their eyes, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I would heal them. Isaiah said this because he saw his glory and spoke about him. Nevertheless, many, even the authorities, believed in him. But because of the Pharisees, they did not acknowledge it openly in order not to be expelled from the synagogue, for they prepared human praise to the glory of God. Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me believes not only in me, but also in the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Please remain standing for the blessing.
His Excellency Jose Cabantan, the Archbishop of Cagayan de Oro, Abbot Emeritus Filomeno Cinco, OCSO of the Trappist Abbey in Guimaras, the Right Reverend Abbot Savio Siccuan, his brothers and his sisters, and also all our Benedictine nuns and sisters, our Benedictine monks of the Manila Abbey and of the Monastery of Digos, our Benedictine Oblates, and all of you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today is a very historical day, and I don't think people realize that this is the first time that an abbot is blessed in Mindanao, because the only abbey, Benedictine abbey in Mindanao so far, is our abbey. Although we already have two abbesses, that is Mother Columba of Digos, of the Eucharistic King, the nuns of the Eucharistic King, and Mother Giovanna, the Trappistine abbess, in Polomolok, in the monastery of the Our Lady of Mount Matutum, still, this is the first time that we have a blessing of a Benedictine abbot. And so our Right Reverend Savio Siccuan is actually making history, because this is really quite, you might say, a very special event. Aside from being the second abbot of this abbey, he is also a person who is already quite versed and well known how it is to be an abbot even before he became one. Normally, before the actual blessing, the archbishop would give him an admonition or an exhortation based on the holy rule. I don't think there is any need for that, because Abbot Savio has been superior of this monastery for 17 long years, and he is aware of his obligations and his responsibilities. And I believe the three of us here, Abbot Savio, myself, Abbot Filomeno, whenever those parts in the Holy Rule are read, that is chapters 2 and chapter 64, on what kind the abbot ought to be, when it is being read, we all realize that all the monks are looking at us as if saying, are you sure you are following the rule to the letter? We have no choice but to close our eyes and look at the ground and say, Lord, for whatever limitations and sometimes, you know, our weaknesses, we hope that you will provide for it. It is interesting that being a Benedictine abbot, I was also wondering why through history, the Benedictine abbot, even the Trappist abbot, and even the abbesses were given the, you might say, privileges, episcopal privileges of the mitre, the ring, and also the staff or the crozier. For 600 long years, the only form of consecrated life was the monastic life. We were not organized, but we were all following the holy rule of Saint Benedict. And not only that, what happened was, because the monasteries flourished very much, what happened was the abbot also became the bishop of the locality where the monastery is found. In other words, they call that a territorial abbey. And the abbot is called an abbot nullius. An abbot nullius means an abbot of no diocese, meaning to say that the monastery was always independent and that the territory, the villages, or the people around the monastery were also under his care. Of course, during this ceremony, Abbot Savio will be given all this insignia of a bishop. The ring, just like in marriage, it is a symbol of eternal life, and life rather, and commitment. And notice that rings are usually made of metal. It is seldom that you will see rings that are made of wood, because metal symbolizes strength and an unbreakable love as long as one lives. He is given the mitre. Many people have tried to explain why he needs this hat, you know, on his head. And some people were saying it is a helmet of protection and salvation. There are two sides to it, and the two sides will represent the Old Testament and the New Testament. In other words, this helmet or this headgear that we have signifies divine brightness and the truth. And finally, of course, the crozier. That is the most important of all symbols, because it symbolizes the good shepherd. In other words, Abbot Savio will have to be a good shepherd. Saint Benedict was quite demanding in the Holy Rule. I have to admit that, and all of us who have been superiors will admit that. In the first chapter, he will say, you have to be firm. But then, towards the end of the rule, he changes his theme. He says, you have to be kind. You have to be compassionate. You have to be merciful. And you know, sometimes I think there is a very delicate balance between being kind and being firm, being merciful and being compassionate. And that balance is only something that is given to us through prayer and through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Saint Benedict was a shrewd realist. He was very down to earth. And of course, when he says there has to be discretion, discretion is a very gentle word. He says to some, you can be humorous. To some, in a way, you have to be restrained. To some, you have to be tenderly. But to others, you have to be stern. It is not easy to do this. And Saint Benedict takes from Saint Augustine, wherein he says, you have to hate the sin, but you have to love the sinner. My, how much we cannot do that. We identify the person with the sin and the sin with the person, and we cannot seem to separate the two. But then, this is what Saint Benedict is saying. What is so special about the Holy Rule is that Saint Benedict takes on the image of the suffering servant. And he says there, in the suffering servant, you should not crush a bruised reed. And again, he takes also the image of Saint Paul. We are all earthenware vessels. We are all made of clay. We are easily broken. And none of us is really as strong as what we ought to be. The real test of authenticity is selfless love. And this is what is being said. We have to be loving in a burning and, you might say, very radiant kind of love. I have to say this. An abbot can only function if the community cooperates with him. An abbot is not apart from the community. The abbot is a personification of the whole community. And we cannot always, you know, so to say, point an accusing finger on the abbot. You know, it is not only the monks who need mercy and compassion. Abbots also need mercy and compassion in the same way that we all are. We are all, you might say, in the very same stage of our lives wherein we have to realize that we are all broken. One of the things, finally, that I just want to say is this. There is a delicate balance between human nature and also, you might say, our capacity, our potential to become the image of Christ. Because the abbot represents Christ, is a personification of Christ. And the whole community should be a personification of Christ. Only through faith can we be able to do this. We are not a human organization, but sometimes we tend to forget because we ourselves become selfish and greedy and put our self-interest beforehand and before the community. When you say faith, that means we have to be overwhelmed by God. And faith also means that we have to trust again and again, because from a human point of view, sometimes trust has been destroyed, and yet we have to hold on. We have, so to speak, you know, really have that energy, have that light, that fire, that passion, that fervor, so that we will be able to hold on to the image of Christ, which is present in all our hearts. Probably, as a closing, we ask for your prayers for Abbot Savio, and not only Abbot Savio, for also our community. The blessing of an abbot is also the blessing of all of the monks. And I hope you don't mind, I listed the names of the monks here in this piece of paper so that I will not forget, because you know how it is at my age. And they will never forgive me for the rest of my life. And these are our monks, and we are proud of them. We are all trying very hard to present Christ to you. We might fail, but again and again, the Holy Spirit will give us that energy and enthusiasm to be what we ought to be. We have here our monks Diego, Joaquin, Simeon, Pacomius, Carlo, Elias, Martin, Joseph, Myron,
Pietro, Arcadius, John Paul, Jared, Pio, Benedict, Giovanni, Marius, and Eugene, and including myself and Abbot Savio, we're already 20 all in all. So, as we continue with this celebration, we ask your fervent prayers for all of us, and we thank you for being present here, because you are the ones who give us support, who give us care, who give us encouragement to be able to be faithful to our vocation. And may God, through the intercession of Saint Benedict, continue to bless us all. Amen.
We will now begin the rite of abbatial blessing with the presentation of the abbot-elect and his examination by the bishop, the archbishop.
We ask you to bless him as abbot of our monastery.
Has he been duly elected?
We know and can testify that he has.
Thanks be to God.
My dear brothers, when a man is chosen to stand in the place of Christ and to guide others in the way of the Spirit, it is right that he should be questioned in the way of the Spirit. It is right that he should be questioned on matters concerning his office and on the qualities he brings to it. This is the old age teaching and requirement of our ancestors in the spiritual life. Following their guidance, I now ask, will you persevere in your determination to observe the rule of Saint Benedict, and will you be diligent in teaching your brothers to do the same, and so encourage them in the love of God, in the life of the gospel, in fraternal charity?
I will.
Will you teach your brothers by your constant dedication to monastic life, by sound doctrine, by the good example of your own deeds, rather than mere words?
I will.
Will you be always concerned for the spiritual good of those entrusted to your care, and seek to lead your brothers to God?
I will.
Will you be faithful in watching over the goods of your monastery and prudent in using them for the benefit of your brothers, of the poor, and of the strangers at your gate?
I will.
Will you always and in all matters be loyal, obedient, reverent to Holy Church and to our Holy Father, the Pope, and his successors?
I will.
May the Lord strengthen your resolve, give you every grace, and keep you always and everywhere in his protection.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, God has chosen Dom Savio, his servant, to be the leader of his brothers. Let us pray that the all-powerful Lord may pour the gifts of heaven upon him and sustain him with his grace.
Please stand for the litany of the saints to be followed by the prayer of blessing.
Lord of mercy. Christ of mercy.
Christ of mercy.
Lord of mercy. your sake.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael, Saint Gabriel, and Saint Raphael,
pray for us.
Holy angels of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
Saint Boniface,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsuan,
pray for us.
Saint John Chrysostom,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory Nazianzen,
pray for us.
Saint Athanasius,
pray for us.
Saint Basil,
pray for us.
Saint Ambrose,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine of Hippo,
pray for us.
Saint Jerome,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory the Great,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine of Canterbury,
pray for us.
Saint Bede,
pray for us.
Saint Anselm,
pray for us.
Saint Bernard,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Avila,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Therese of the Child Jesus,
pray for us.
All holy doctors and bishops,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony,
pray for us.
Saint Pacomius,
pray for us.
Saint Martin,
pray for us.
Our Holy Father Benedict,
pray for us.
Saint Columban,
pray for us.
Saint Bruno,
pray for us.
Saint Romuald and Saint Peter Damian,
pray for us.
Saint Robert, Saint Alberic, and Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Scholastica,
pray for us.
Saint Gertrude and Saint Hildegard,
pray for us.
Saint Francis of Rome,
pray for us.
All holy monastics and hermits,
pray for us.
Saint Dominic and Saint Francis,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us.
Saint John Paul II,
pray for us.
Saint John the 23rd,
pray for us.
Saint Dominic Savio.
Pray for us.
Blessed Columba Marmio.
Pray for us.
Blessed Carlo Acutis.
Pray for us.
All holy men and women.
Pray for us.
Lord, be merciful. From all evil.
Lord, save your people.
From every sin.
Lord, save your people.
From everlasting death.
Lord, save your people.
By your coming as man. By your death and rising to a new life. By your gift of the Holy Spirit. Be merciful to us, sinners. Guide and protect your holy church.
Lord,
keep the Pope and all the clergy in faithful service to your church.
Lord,
bring together all people in trust and peace.
Lord,
strengthen us in your service.
Lord,
bless this chosen one. Bless this chosen one and make him holy. Bless this chosen one, make him holy, and consecrate him for his abbatial duties. Jesus, Son of the Living God.
Lord, hear
our prayer. Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Almighty God and Father, you sent your only Son into the world to be the servant of all, the good shepherd who lays down his life for his sheep. Listen to our prayer. Bless and strengthen Dom Savio, your servant, chosen to be the abbot of this monastery. His manner of life shows clearly that he is what he is called for, a father, so that his teaching will as a living of goodness grow in the hearts of his spiritual family. Let him realize, O Lord, how demanding is the task to which he now sets his hand, how heavy the responsibility of guiding the souls of others and of ministering to the many and various needs of a community. Let him seek to help his brothers rather than to preside over them. Give them a heart full of compassion, wisdom, and zeal, so that he may not lose even one of the flocks entrusted to his charge. May he dispose all things with understanding, so that the members of the monastic family will steadily make progress in the love of Christ and of each other, and run with eager hearts in the way of your commandments. Give him the gifts of your Spirit. Set him on fire with love for your glory and for the service of your church. And may he in turn inflame the zeal with hearts, the hearts of his brothers. In his life and in his teaching, may set Christ above all things. And when the day of judgment dawns, receive him in the company of his brothers into your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. We will now have the presentation of the Holy Rule and of the pontifical insignia, the ring, mitre, and crozier.
Take this rule, which contains the description of holiness, and receive from our spiritual ancestors. As God gives you strength and human frailty allows, your brothers, God placed in your care. Take this ring, the seal of fidelity, wear it as a seal of constancy, and maintain this monastic family and the bond of brotherly love. Take this shepherd's crozier and show loving care for the brothers whom the Lord has entrusted to you, for he will demand an account of your stewardship.
The Archbishop will now lead the Abbot Savio to his abbatial chair for his installation. Let us give Abbot Savio a round of applause. The kiss of peace follows to be given by his monks. Please be seated.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, that having meditated on your word, following the example of Saint Jerome, we may come eagerly draw near to offer your majesty the sacrifice of salvation. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the oblation of your servants, and grant that offering themselves as a spiritual sacrifice, they may be constantly filled with true humility, with obedience, and with peace through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. He is the unblemished flower who sprung from the root of the Virgin and declared the pure of heart blessed, teaching by his way of life and surpassing worth of chastity. He chose always to hold fast to what is pleasing to you and becoming obedient for our sake, even until death. He willingly offered himself to you as a perfect and a fragrant sacrifice. He was consecrated to a fuller service of your majesty. Those who for love of you leave all earthly things and promised they would find treasure in heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her chaste spouse, with your beloved apostles and glorious martyrs, with our Holy Father Benedict, our Holy Mother Saint Scholastica, Saint Jerome, Saint Francis of Assisi, Saint Dominic Savio, Blessed Carlo Acutis, Saint Catherine of Siena, and Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, and with all the saints in this constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Noel, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, this your servant Savio, who today has been chosen as abbot of our community, with all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, especially Regulo and Corazon, Siccuan, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. For all who are following the live streaming of this Mass and are unable to receive Holy Communion sacramentally, let us pray the spiritual communion that Pope Francis proposes. Let us pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. This we ask through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Where there is
Please stand.
Let us pray. May these holy gifts we have received, O Lord, as we rejoice in celebrating Saint Jerome, stir up the hearts of your faithful, so that attentive to your sacred teachings, they may understand the path they are to follow, and by following it obtain life everlasting. Look with favor on your family, Lord, and grant that we have celebrated the mystery of faith, may he send tirelessly along the path of the gospel, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Archbishop Cabantan will now give his message, to be followed by Abbot Emeritus Filomeno Cinco, and finally Abbot Savio's message of thanks, after which Abbot Savio will go around to bless the faithful while the monks sing the Te Deum Laudamus, a hymn of thanksgiving.
I would just like to express our warmest congratulations to Abbot Savio, and also a message of thanksgiving to the whole community and to Abbot Ed. First, our heartfelt greetings to Abbot Savio and to the community of this Abbey of the Transfiguration. As the new Abbot, like Job, in our first reading, we know you can only wonder with awe and gratefulness how God works mysteriously in your life. You have been a prior to this monastery prior to your election as the new Abbot in this Abbey. God must have prepared you for this beyond our understanding and beyond your understanding, where you can only say yes to God. Thank you for your fiat so that this Abbey will continue its mission in the Church. This Abbey has been a place of solitude for all of us, a place of refuge, a place of prayer, contemplation, communion with our loving God. We know very well that monastic life brings action and contemplation together. In fact, your presence here reminds us always of this essential reality in our lives. With this, I would like also to express my heartfelt gratitude to Abbot Ed. He is the first abbot I encountered in my life. That was also historical. Just as we witness here the historical event in the Church of Mindanao, the blessing of Abbot Savio. You know, when we were in theology, in St. John Vianney Theological Seminary, we were together with Dom Savio, my classmate. We have Dom Carlo, Father Elias, Father Paco, and Abbot Savio is our contemporary at the seminary. They brought us here sometimes in 1987 or 1988 for their celebrations, and I believe that was their profession, and to witness to their profession. And I said that was the first time we had visited a monastery and also encountered the monks and encountered Father Adag, the late Father Adag, Dom Bernie, and of course, as I've said, the first time we encountered and see for ourselves an abbot in the person of Abbot Ed. For us, monastic life is a school of service in the Church. According to Saint Benedict, and true enough, I and many of us here will affirm that truth. An abbey is never just a commune of individual monks living together in one place. It is rather a community which is part of the public life of the Church, which even though they are here in this monastery, they give public visibility to the life of faith, to the values which must be underpinned the world and which can keep us together as a community. I thank Father Abbot and all of them personally, of the times I spent here during those years when I was assigned here for the past 10 years. Here we realize it is only through humility and interiority that we can be more like Christ to reach our human fulfillment, the call of each one of us, as Abbot Ed said in his homily. Through faith and by the grace of God, we will be able to really witness to ourselves as an image of God's love. To Abbot Savio, rest assured of our prayers for you and the community as you take on your new office. Learning from Saint Benedict on your role as the personification of the Abbey, which was also mentioned by Abbot Ed, and a sort of an autobiography of himself, the more we will pray for you. Like us who exercises authority in the church, or just like parents here exercising authority in your families, we're always challenged how to be truly servant leaders. Servant leadership is a gift that we continually beg from God's mercy. We are always inspired by the words of Jesus telling us not to be afraid. We pray for you, Abbot Savio, that the Holy Spirit fills you with his wisdom as you lead this abbey. As you said in one of your homilies, you said, with the Holy Spirit, you live a life full of enthusiasm, full of creativity, and above all, with God's immense love. This is taken from your homily. I copy your homily also. May you remain spiritually young with the freshness of the love of God for you. And with a humble heart, may you be able to listen well and discern together with the community what the Lord wishes you to attain for the Abbey and for the whole church. Again, congratulations and God bless you.
This wonderful liturgical celebration of the Abbatial Blessing of Abbot Savio is now coming to its happy conclusion. And everything that needs to be spoken and sung has been done so beautifully, solemnly. And may the memories, and especially the graces, that this celebration brings continue to live on effectively in your lives. What is left is to give you the kiss, not physically, not individually, but keep it simple and sweet. Keep it simple, sweet. Daghan salamat kaayo sa inyo tanan. Maraming salamat po. Thank you very much.
His Excellency, the Archbishop of Cagayan de Oro, Archbishop Jose Cabantan, the Abbot Emeritus of the Trappist Monks in Guimaras, Abbot Philomenos Cinco, my predecessor, our dear Abbot Eduardo Africa, the founder of this beautiful abbey, my brother priests, my brother monks, dear sisters, fellow religious, dear oblates, my family, my dear relatives, dear friends of the monastery, good morning. I'll try to, I won't do my Thanksgiving speech in hierarchical order because I might, once I remember one thing, I have to say my word of gratitude immediately. This will take time, so please make yourself comfortable, so, as they say. And this is an opportunity also for you to know me as a person and to open my heart also to my monks. You know, the monks know, my brother monks know, I tend to be secretive, you know, just like my siblings. So we are unobtrusive. We are unassuming. We know who we are. So first of all, I'd like to thank, lest I forget, the pianist and the cellist of today's liturgy. I could listen to them all day. That's Anna, the head of the music department of Lourdes College, and the cellist is EJ. Thank you so much. I could listen to you all day, and I promise you they're coming back. Next one, the head of the Benedictine Confederation is what we call the Abbot Primate, who happens to be my one-time mentor in the Holy Land when I took a one-month course on the prophet Isaiah. Abbot Gregory Polan, he sent me an email which he knows I can share with you. And really the content of the letter is this: Dear Abbot Savio, this letter carries my fraternal best wishes to you and to your community at Malaybalay. As we have known each other from a number of situations of studying in the Holy Land, studying Italian in Assisi, we were classmates in one class, and then meeting here in Rome. I am happy to greet your community and to send my fraternal best wishes with the hope that sometime in the coming few years, it will be possible for me to come to the Philippines to visit your community, meet each of you, and especially to see my former student. May God bless all the endeavors of your community. May you grow in faith, and may the blessing of the new superior, Abbot Savio, bring joy and peace to your community. Let us pray for one another. Fraternally in Christ, Right Reverend Gregory Polan, OSB, Abbot Primate of the Benedictine Confederation. The next one, knowing that this liturgy, this abbatial blessing, is being streamed online, most of you know that I have been in Rome in our generalate for the past 3 years. And if they're watching right now, my beloved community in Rome, San Ambrogio, my dear Abbot President Guillermo Arboleda Tamayo, our procurator, Father Paolo, my confreres, Father Christoph and Father Roberto, our very small community in Rome. And I'd like to thank you for the support when I was in Rome for the past 3 years. I have this anecdote with my Abbot President. As I was packing my things to finally return to the Philippines, the Abbot President said to me, "You know, you leave some of your baggages behind. In case you don't get elected as Abbot, you can always return to Rome. But still, if you get elected as abbot, you have a reason to come back to us. Beautiful. Thank you so much. Our dear abbot president, out of obedience to him, I finished my licentiate in spirituality in the University of St. Thomas, that's the Angelicum in Rome. And I'm currently doing my doctorate in spirituality. But now that I've been elected, I think that is to be put to a hold. We will see. The next thing I want to say is following the cue of Abbot Eduardo, of course the bishop, when I accepted this position as abbot, I have been a superior, the prior of the monastery for 16 years. 2001 to 2009, I was appointed by Rome, prior administrator. 2009 to 2017, as elected prior. They call it the conventual prior. For 16 years of being superior, I know what it means. I know what it means to be crucified. I have no more illusions about being a superior. In fact, as my confreres know, you know, the first monks of Saint Benedict, they tried to poison him. So, and our late Father Columbano would say to me when I was still prior, Father Prior, there are other ways of poisoning the superior. Okay, so may he rest in peace. So I enter once again this role of superior, being aware of the realities, of the strengths and the weaknesses of the monastic community. When I got elected last August 8, from then on until today, how has my life been? To be honest with you, it can be very exhausting. Just by talking to your fellow monks, I'm also in charge of very easily 200 lay employees of the monastery. They also come to the superior for their problems. So practically day in and day out, that's my life now. I find myself having breakfast close to lunch. And one time, I'm really telling myself, you know, this is insane. No? And in my insanity, I chose to accept an office of insanity. So I wonder how Archbishop Jose preserves his insanity. So it's not anymore sanity. But I have two inspirations. That's, I think, my point here. This beautiful article I read some time ago, you people in the world, they are so madly in love with the world. And there are very few people who are madly in love with God. I took this office as abbot because, I've said this before, I do not want to spend the rest of my life being madly in love with myself. You know, when the brothers come to me, when the workers come to me, they draw me out of myself. And God is fulfilling my dream, as Jesus said, to pour out my life for my brothers and sisters, for the church. The other inspiration why I took this role again is because, you know, an abbot has a coat of arms, and he picks a motto. The motto for my abbacy is, Divine Mercy Alone. Let me explain. You know, I've been a seminarian with the Dominicans. I've been in the religious life almost forever. You know, in all these years, I can say in all honesty, it's good Father Matt is here, the confessor of the monks, no? If he were to reveal my sins, who would survive? So, and we also have, of course, my student here, the rector, the new rector of St. John Vianney Theological Seminary, Father Bobby Sena, and then he was my student. Let's give him a round of applause. Of course, Father Matt Sanchez is like 89 years old. So we hope our sins won't hasten your departure. So let's also give him a round of applause. And my other student, who's an exorcist in Cagayan de Oro, June Balsamo. Father. So he's the exorcist in Cagayan de Oro. And I was telling my monks, let us go to confession before he arrives. There's something bad happens during the abbatial blessing. So obviously he's not sensing anything as of now. So the other inspiration is, you know, I know who I am. I know my brothers know I'm a very weak person. And then God has shown me so much mercy. And, you know, I want to say this. Perhaps what I'm going to say can be exaggerated, but, you know, only in the end it's between you and God. And if I say I'm a very sinful person, I take my cue from St. Augustine, who said, whoever I may be, Lord, I lie exposed to you. Let that be the last word. So I take this knowing that I'm a weak person only because of God's mercy. Let me share that mercy to my monks and to the people around me. I'd like to thank, of course, again, our dear Archbishop for presiding. Archbishop Jose, as he said, we were together in St. John Vianney Theological Seminary. He was like our kuya, our model. And I cannot forget that day, Your Excellency, that Wednesday afternoon in the seminary, you said to me, Savio, let's go watch a movie. Because during those times, the seminarians, Wednesday afternoons, they go down to the city, watch a movie. I declined the offer of Jose. Your Excellency, I hope you invite me again to watch a movie. We have to be very careful. Perhaps when you are in Rome, we can go watch a movie. They won't know. Or when you are in Switzerland. And again, thank you so much, Archbishop. You are always welcome. This is your home, monastery, if you want quiet. And also for the clergy of Cagayan de Oro and Malaybalay. Abbot Philomeno Cinco, thank you so much. Abbot Phil, as we call him, is like a father to the community. Since the beginning of when we were in the old monastery, he gives us retreats and talks. He knows our journey. So Abbot Phil, thank you so much. Of course, the Trappist, when I think of the life of the Trappists in Guimaras, I feel bad because they wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning to say vigils. We here, we wake up at 3 o'clock. So I feel bad because we are 1 hour late. Thank you so much for the example. Now I turn to Abbot Eduardo Africa. I think there are some things I'm going to say, which are the first things I'm going to say to him and to my monastic community. Abbot Ed, thank you for having the vision to found this beautiful abbey. Let's give him a round. You know, you go in any church somewhere in the Philippines, who can beat, you know, this beautiful place. It was Abbot Ed who had me ordained to the priesthood. It was Abbot Ed who, in his vision, sent me abroad for further studies. And for the first time, I'd like to thank you, Abbot Ed, because you sent me to my dream, a school for monastic studies in the U.S. That's in St. John's University, Collegeville, Minnesota. When we think of Collegeville, it's the school for monastic studies. Thank you so much. When I left 2017 to do my sabbatical, and Abbot Ed, with his gift of being a builder, he repaired this church. He built many beautiful structures. So I come back, everything is already fixed. Thank you so much, Abbot Ed. It's like, salamat po, pinagbakasyon niyo ako. But of course, without really saying it, so grateful to Abbot Ed because of this monastery, countless souls have been brought closer to God. I want to thank, he's watching now, the Abbot of San Beda Abbey. He is now in a Trappist monastery in Vina. Abbot Austin, thank you for supporting the monastery. Abbot Austin is on a sabbatical. And Abbot Austin, thank you for the monks you've sent here. I want to acknowledge them now. Father Anthony of San Beda Alabang. Father Angelo of San Beda Taytay. Our newly ordained priest, that's Father Patrick, also of Alabang. Father John Paul, San Beda, Manila. And of course, very grateful to our deacon, Reverend Don Martin. Thank you for singing the gospel. So, I'd like to thank also the other monks who came here, the monks from Digos, Davao, Brother Cyril and Reinhardt. Brother Lito was with Abbot Phil. They came from Matutum. Our Trappist nuns. Benedictine nuns, of course, Sister Geraldine. And thank you so much. And all the sisters, our neighbors, and all the oblates, whether in Manila or in Bukidnon. Now, bear with me, I still have some more. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of a very good friend of the monastery, a personal friend of mine, our ex-PNP chief, General Archie Gamboa. Archie was the one who really, one of the few people who supported me in my studies in Rome. Thank you so much, Archie. So I'd like to acknowledge the presence of a couple who just came from Geneva, Switzerland. Gemma and Christopher Aliana, kindly rise. Are they still here? Gemma and Christopher Aliana, they're just somewhere. There they are. Thank you so much. So, behind the Montes Claroses. So, thank you so much. The reason why I acknowledge them is, when I have a break from studies in Assisi, we have the leisure to go somewhere in Europe. So I was fortunate enough to have found a Filipino community in Geneva. So they took very good care of me. And perhaps when I get very stressed, you know, I can fly to Geneva or to Italy. Or lately, I've discovered Mirayon. I want to acknowledge now, and I want to say this for the very first time, my deepest gratitude to a family who have taken very good care of me as a prior, as a monk, and the times I was away from the past 5 years, Tirso, Esther, and the children, the Montes Claros. Thank you so much. I want to acknowledge a clan that is watching now from Temple City, California, the Viernes family. No, I won't give particular names lest I forget someone. Thank you so much for supporting me also all these years. The Viernes family from California. I'd like to thank all the benefactors now of the Abbey, all benefactors of me personally, my barkada in Valencia, my barkada in Malaybalay, my barkada in Manila. Thank you so much. The men's choir, of course, thank you so much, as always. The church decoration, of course, and the shapnos. Okay, thank you so much. Let's give them a round of applause. So, lest I forget, of course, they might be anxious. Father has forgotten us, my siblings. That's Rosario, and that's my nephew, Gabriel, my niece, Manolita, my elder brother, that's Rodolfo, my youngest brother, Regulo, and then my elder sister, Remedios. It's the first time we were gathered together here in the monastery. Now, we are already orphans, so this abbatial blessing has brought us together. So. And I'm proud to acknowledge my relatives, really proud, the De Albans. I'll just call the patriarchs, Uncle Josephine De Alban, Uncle Emilio, no one else. So, and the rest are my cousins. And yeah, cousins, no? So thank you so much for coming. You know, I look up to them because, you know, if I'm an abbot, in terms of the Catholic faith, they are the staunch pillars of the faith. So I look up to you. Your presence here means so much to me. So, very quickly, it's Abraham, Auntie Amy, Auntie Glo, and Kim, that's Diego, Alfonsus, Jubilee, and Margarita, where are you? There they are. Did I miss anyone? Dominic, of course. Why should I forget Dominic? Thank you so much. And the last two things. Now I address myself to my monks. As a father of the community, I now open my heart to my monks. Abbot Ed, as I was telling Archbishop, as the gift of being a visionary and a builder, Abbot Eduardo. I was telling one time Abbot Ed, you know, Abbot Ed, I don't have those gifts. So, and then Abbot Ed said to me, the monastery in the end is not about structures. The monastery in the end is about the monks. And so what do I say to my monks now? What is my vision for each of you? You know, we can only be useful in the church if we try to be true monks, meaning, this is what I really want to say now. You know, we entered the monastery really serious in our prayer. And I want my monks to cultivate profundity in their prayer life, you know, to be the best they can be with the particular gifts God has given them. The monks of this abbey are very talented. And we can only be fruitful to the church with so many people coming to the abbey if the monks themselves, especially the abbot, has that fire within to put the people who come here on fire with the love of God. Or in the words of Reyniero Cantalamessa, we can only be fruitful in the church if we have that intimacy with God. And that is my dream for my monks. In other words, I want all my monks to be saints. And we can only be fruitful to the church if the monks themselves are on fire with God. Lastly, how I wish my father and my mother were here. And I want to address them now. Your training has led me to this. Thank you, Tai, Nai. And I think there's one thing you want me to do. Now that I'm abbot, it has to be this. I want to say this very well. If my tata and nanay would want us to do one thing, you love the Virgin Mary so much. And so I begin my abbacy in honor of the Divine Mercy, everything through the Blessed Virgin Mary. Everything. After this, that's over. I'm sorry. Because now I shall be giving my blessing to all of you in the fashion of Pope Francis. I will go around and give the sign of the cross and say, repent and be converted. So, just give the sign of the cross. Thank you so much. Pray for me.
Thank you.
Please remain standing for the solemn blessing, after which the hymn to Our Lady of Montserrat will be sung, and the recessional and picture-taking follows.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings.
May God, from whom all fatherhood takes its name, grant that you be strengthened with the power in your inner self, according to the riches of his glory.
Amen.
May God grant you to hasten in the way of his commands, in company with your brothers, open-heartedly and in the joy of Christ.
Amen.
By the grace of God, may this monastic family, gathered in the name of the Lord, come with you as guide to a heavenly way of life.
Amen.
And may the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain in you forever and ever.
Amen.
Oh,
Thank you very much, Archbishop Jose Cabantan, Abbot Emeritus Filomeno Cinco, and Abbot Emeritus Eduardo Africa. We will continue with our picture taking. We would like to call our monastic community to please come forward. All the monks of our Transfiguration, of our Abbey of the Transfiguration, here in Malaybalay. Thank you, Brother Monks. Our next group we would like to call the visiting monks, our friends from Digos, our brother monks from San Beda, together with the concelebrants of our Mass today. So once again, we'd like to call the visiting monks and all the concelebrants of our Mass. After the photo taking of the visiting monks and concelebrants, all the family and relatives of Father Savio, please stand by. Thank you very much. Dear visiting monks and concelebrants, we would like to call upon the family and relatives of our dear Abbot Savio to please come forward. The family and relatives of Father Savio, please come forward.